So let's start the topic polar plot. Polar plot. It is a graphical plot. It is a graphical plot based on the forward path transfer function. Not only the forward path transfer function, based on the open loop transfer function, which is GSHS. Which is GSHS. And since we are studying the frequency domain analysis, we are using frequency domain analysis. And in frequency domain analysis, first plot is polar plot. So, first of all, we replace this S by J omega for sinusoidal frequency response. For sinusoidal frequency response. Right? It means the polar plot is dependent on G J omega H J omega. Right? And what is G J omega H J omega? It is the sinusoidal frequency response. Sinusoidal transfer function of the open loop transfer function. Right? And this polar plot gives us the absolute as well as relative stability. The absolute as well as relative stability. And by viewing the plot, by analyzing the plot, we can say that the system is stable or not. We do not have to calculate the values to identify the system's stability. Right? Polar plot is a graphical plot which gives us the stability of the system. Right? So, rules for drawing polar plot. Rules for drawing polar plot. First is substitute S is equal to J omega in the open loop transfer function. First substitute S is equal to J omega in the open loop transfer function. Second, write the expression for magnitude and phase. Magnitude and phase of G J omega H J omega. Third, compute the values of magnitude of g j omega h j omega and angle g j omega h j omega for omega is equal to 0 and omega is equal to infinity. Or it would be better to write omega tends to 0 and omega tends to infinity. Fourth, check whether the polar plot intersects. Check whether the polar plot intersects the real axis by making the imaginary part of g j omega h j omega to 0. And at this value of omega, compute the magnitude and phase of g j omega h j omega. Fifth, check whether the polar plot intersects the imaginary axis by making the real part of g j omega h j omega to 0. And again, at this value of omega, compute magnitude of g omega h j omega and angle, right? And rule number 6, sketch the polar plot with the help of above informations. with the help of above informations. So, what is the rules? What are the rules for plotting polar plot? First, substitute S is equal to J omega in GSHS. And as we put S is equal to J omega, we will find G J omega H J omega. Then write the magnitude and angle expressions for G J omega H G omega. From magnitude and angle expressions, compute the value of magnitude and angle when omega tends to 0 and omega tends to infinite. Omega tends to 0 and omega tends to infinite. And the polar plot starts from omega is equal to 0 and end up to omega is equal to infinity. Polar plot moves from omega is equal to 0 to infinity, means plus 0 to plus infinity. When omega's value will be positive, then only we'll draw the polar plot. Right. So polar plot starts from omega is equal to 0 and end up to omega is equal to infinity. Then check whether the polar plot intersects the real axis. And where the polar plot will intersect the real axis? When the imaginary part of this G J omega H J omega will be 0. So first write this G J omega H J omega in the form of real and imaginary term and put the imaginary term to 0, and as we'll put it to 0, we'll find the value of omega from here, and at that value of omega we have to find the magnitude and angle of G J omega H J omega. Right. Again, check whether the polar plot intersects the imaginary axis, and where this polar plot will intersect the imaginary axis. The polar plot will intersect the imaginary axis. The polar plot will intersect the imaginary axis when real part of this G G omega H G omega is 0. And similarly, as from here also we will find the value of omega. And at that value of omega, we have to compute magnitude and angle. Right? And from all these informations, from all these values, we'll plot our polar plot. We'll sketch our polar plot. Right? Let's see an example. And before starting an example, let us introduce a G J omega H J omega plot. G J omega H J omega plane. Here we have imaginary, here we have real axis. imaginary axis and real axis. This is much more like S plane. Much more like S plane. And it is different from S plane only by the origin. It is different from the S plane only by the origin. In GJ omega, HJ omega or GSHS plane, in GSHS plane, the origin will change with in comparison to S plane. So initially we will consider GJ omega plane, GJ omega, HJ omega plane and S plane both are same. And initially we are considering that origin is at zero. Right? If I move anti-clockwise like this, then our angle will be positive. Like here we have 0 degree, here we have 90 degree plus 90 degree. Here we have plus 180 degree, here we have plus 270 degree. And again here we have plus 360 degree, right? And we are moving anti-clockwise. So whenever we will move anti-clockwise, then angle will be positive. And whenever we will move clockwise, angle will be negative. So when we will move anti-clockwise, here we will have minus 90 degree. Here we will have minus 180 degree. Here we will have minus 270 degree. And here we will have minus 360 degree, right? So for sketching the polar plot, we will consider the negative angles, right? And for negative angles, on this axis downward, we have minus 90 degree, means this line is for minus 90 degree, this line is for minus 180 degree line, and this line is for minus 270 degree. And here we have 0 degree and minus 360 degree, right? Now come to an example. We have GS HS is equal to 5 divided by S plus 1. 5 divided by S plus 1. What is the type of system? 0. It is a type 0 system. Right? Type 0 system. By replacing S with J omega, we have G J omega H J omega is equal to 5 divided by J omega plus 1. What is the magnitude? It is M is equal to magnitude G J omega H J omega. G J omega H J omega, and this will be equal to 5 divided by magnitude of this 1 plus omega square under root, right? And what will be the angle? Let's say theta. Angle G J omega H J omega. What is the angle for this 5? 0 degree. And what is the angle for this tan inverse omega? And since this is in denominator, so angle is minus tan inverse omega. Right? Now, write this function in terms of real and imaginary part. So this will become 1 minus j omega. So 5 minus j 5 omega divided by 1 plus omega square. Right? Now, so what are the steps for plotting polar plot? First, replace S by J omega. We have replaced S by J omega. Find the magnitude and angle of G J omega, H J omega. We have find magnitude and angle. And compute magnitude and angle when omega is equal to 0 and infinity. So limit omega tends to 0, m. As omega tends to 0, m is equal to 5. And as omega tends to 0, what is theta? As omega tends to 0, this is 0. Okay? Limit omega tends to infinity, m. What will be the value of m as omega tends to infinity? As omega tends to infinity, this goes to 0. And limit omega tends to infinity theta, what will be the value of theta? As I put here infinity, tan inverse infinity will be 90 degree. So, we have minus 90 degree. Minus 90 degree. Right? Then, intersection point on real axis. For real axis intersection, for real intersection, imaginary part will be 0, 5 omega divided by 1 plus omega square is equal to 0. And what is the condition when this term will be 0? First condition is this, omega is equal to 0. And second condition, when this omega will be infinity, then also this term will be 0. Right? Now, next is find the value of magnitude and angle on these values. So, we have already calculated magnitude and angle when omega 0 and infinity, and for imaginary intersection, put the real part to 0. So 5 divided by 1 plus omega square is equal to 0. And when this value will be 0, only when the omega is equal to infinity. Means at omega is equal to infinity, the polar plot will intersect real as well as imaginary axis, and any plot will intersect both the axes at the same time only at the origin. Only at the origin. Right? Now, let us plot with these values. I told you that polar plot will start from omega is equal to 0 and end up to omega is equal to infinity. So, when omega is equal to 0, magnitude is 5. When omega is equal to 0, magnitude is 5. And angle, what is angle? And omega is equal to 0, it is 0. So, which one is 0 degree line? 0 degree line is this. So, on this 0 degree line, we have magnitude 5. Here we have 5. Right? Here we have 5. Infinity. When omega is equal to infinity, magnitude is 0. Magnitude is 0. And what is the angle? Angle is minus 90. It means the polar plot will end like this or like this. Right? The polar plot will end like this or like this and will start like this or like this. Right? Now, if the polar plot starts from here and end up to here, then it is necessary to intersect the imaginary axis. Right? Then it is necessary to intersect on the imaginary axis. But where the polar plot intersects the imaginary axis? At omega is equal to infinity. And at omega is equal to infinity, magnitude is 0, angle is minus 90. It means this is not the intersection point, and therefore the polar plot will be like this only. Right? Polar plot will be like this only. Okay. If I move from here and end up to here, then this will be like this. Again, the polar plot should intersect here and here. But the polar plot never intersect the imaginary axis other than origin. So, this is not true. The only polar plot can make from these values is this. Right? Right? So, like this, we can sketch our polar plot for any open loop transfer function. Right? So, in the next video, we'll take some more examples, we'll solve some more examples regarding polar plot. Thank you.